Gracias. Gracias por su invitación, pero es solo en español. I continue in English. Impact of tourism is one of the subjects of this summit, and it's not only about vacation rental, and it's not only about Airbnb. Of course, Airbnb and all those other websites are very important, but we should not forget that, for instance, in Amsterdam, there are 13 million people staying in hotels every year and 1 million in holiday vacation rental homes. So it's still a very large part of, let's say, traditional tourism. It's clear that the growing number of tourism has a great impact on the territory of the cities. It's a fact, also in Amsterdam. Every year we see a growing number of residents and a growing number of tourists. So the city is growing very fast, and we can't cope with that in number of houses that we build. And tourism, growing of tourism, is a worldwide autonomous trend. And Amsterdam and cities like Barcelona and all the cities that are very attractive at the moment, it's a fact. In the past, we must admit that Amsterdam, and not only Amsterdam, I think many cities, have stimulated tourism. Partly because of this, Amsterdam survived the financial crisis relatively well. So we owe a lot to tourism as well. But the city board of Amsterdam also acknowledges that the times have changed. Public space has become scarce, and it is difficult to cope with the big crowds, especially in the city center. The city has to be in balance, a balance between residents, visitors, and business. And that's why Amsterdam opts for grip on growth, with measures that reduce nuisance for residents and spread tourism. And its program we call City in Balance, and I will point out some highlights of it. I will not point out everything, because then it takes a few hours. What we try to do is make it practical and visible for our citizens by taking structural measures and experimental measures. To mention a few of the structural measures we have taken is, first of all, and not an important one, is we limit the growth of hotels. And especially in the city center of Amsterdam, we don't give any permits anymore for new hotels. We are still building some hotels because we gave permits in the recent past. So these ones have to be honored. And in the other boroughs out of the city center and the neighboring districts, we have a policy of no unless. Unless a new hotel fits in the neighborhood, is innovative, sustainable, and has a high degree of quality. So a new hotel has to stand out amidst the already existing hotels. And this also will limit the growth of hotels. What we talked about yesterday in the first part of the meeting, the second part is very important, is enforcement on illegal hotels. The vacation rental, which is not vacation rental, it's not sharing your home for a few weeks or maximum of 2 months in Amsterdam, but when in fact you do it all the time and you are not living in your apartment. This enforcement is very important, and therefore we established more enforcement teams with higher fines. There's a hotline every day, and we added in the last years 3.5 million euro extra to our enforcement budget. And we also do it for houseboats, by the way, which are very popular in Amsterdam, but they are also to live in and not for tourists. We are going to differentiate the tourist tax. Inside the city ring, we increase the tourist tax, and outside we decrease it. This will not really have an effect on the flow of tourism, we think, but it will mean extra income, and that will be used for things that are very important for our residents, as things as keeping the city center clean, more cleaning up, not only during the night or during the morning, but also during the day. We will have less big events in the city. We have our share of big events, and every year they attract larger crowds. And we will give less permits, and we will facilitate the sector in keeping these events on locations just outside the city. Less cars in the city, less parking space, more bicycle lanes. Touring cars out of the city center. At this moment, we still have transfer points in the city center, for example, near the central station, and we will remove these point to these transfer points to points further away. Less or no fun activities, like the cities often have these days, like beer cycles, beer boats, beer floating festivals, and all those tech parties you have on the squares. We will revoke permits and we don't give new ones. There's plenty of beer for sale still in Amsterdam, but in the pubs. And together with the organizers of events, we will clean the city faster during and after each event. Lower speed limits for boats in the canals, meaning less noise and other nuisance for the houseboats, and less traffic jams on the water, because indeed we have nowadays in the summer traffic jams in the canals. And we will invest in more recreational and cultural activities in the outskirts of the city. These are structural measures. We also have a lot of experiments, more than 30. I will not explain all of this, because sometimes they are very small and restricted to just an area or just the street. For example, creating a food street in Amsterdam East, where it's a district with a population with many different ethnic backgrounds, so also many different cuisines. And that's a nice way of attracting people to other parts of the city that are not so crowded. We want to influence bad behavior, by special teams who address tourists, but also Amsterdam people, who are also notorious when they are on their cycles. And we try to seek cooperation with the people in the field that can support behavioral change. Special apps for leading people from A to B, but not through the city center, but along other interesting sites and musea we have in the city. We have hundreds of them, but we all talk about the Anne Frank House and the Rijksmuseum and the Van Gogh Museum, but there's so much more we can offer in Amsterdam. So these are some measures. We call that city in balance. We do that apart from all the measures we take on vacational rental. You could say vacation rental is just a part of all the measures we take for trying to cope with mass tourism, not trying to bother it. We still feel that Amsterdam is a very attractive city, and we like tourists, but we don't like them all at the same place at the same time. I think that's the big problem at this moment. Thank you.